Okay, here we are. This is Q&A number 20. And our first question is from Chloe. And it's in relation to the respiration of Earth. She says, Geoff mentions that tribal people are aware of the connection between animals congregating underground and where rain will fall due to the exchange of energy. This fascinates Chloe, and she wants me to elaborate further on where and how this can be observed. Where can I read this and more? Well, the respiration of Earth relates to the movement of the tide, which is pulled by the moon. So the gravity pull of the moon actually lifts the oceans of the Earth, which we see as a tide. Now that continues to happen in the aquifers underground and with soil moisture. So there's a bulge, a tidal bulge drawn towards the moon underneath the soil as well. As that bulges, the groundwaters rise and the air in the soil is exhaled. And then as the low tide goes past, as the wave goes past and it goes to a low ebb, that's the low tide. So it draws in. So the earth itself is exhaling and inhaling from the pull of the gravity of the moon, pulling the tides. So with the low tide and the high tide, as it spins round the earth, we get this effect. So with that, animals that live underground create different variations of electrostatic ions. There's different electrical charges from the energy of burrows of animals that live underground. And all animals that live underground, no matter how small or no matter how large, set up their burrows so they have an intake of air and an output of air. Otherwise, they just gas themselves. So it's a natural system. Otherwise, the animals that don't learn to do this don't breed on because they do gas themselves. So there's a self-exhausting. They face their burrows towards the incoming air, and the air is exhausted out. Now, with this is also the breathing of the earth itself. Now, this can affect rain downwind, right? It can affect thunderstorm strikes. Now, this may not have been scientifically understood in a conventional way by tribal people, but it's been observed. Well, real science is really the observation of events that we then relate to. It's not necessarily that we create science. We haven't created anything. We've observed events and we've assembled things in crazy orders. Creation is something completely different. So tribal people looked at these events and realized this knowledge could be passed on with story. Like the prairie dogs in North America, they say are singing for the rain or crying for the rain. And if you remove the prairie dogs, you'll remove the rain. It's not a very scientific approach with a song and a tradition, but the reality is that the effect of all the prairie dog burrows across the prairie did affect the rain. It did affect rain. So as designers, we can include this potential in our designs. Now, to find information about this, I'm not sure that there's one book that actually covers it all, or there's a book written particularly about this subject. This is information that you have to extract, possibly chapter or paragraph by paragraph, or even sentence by sentence, out of lots of different books. You have to look for that tribal knowledge and analyze it from traditional people, the writings where people have written about the traditions of people. And Bill Mollison often said this, that there are so many books to be written in relation to how that works with permaculture design, how that particular subject. So what we have to do at the moment is we have to mine our way through lots of books. We have to read lots of books and find those chapters, find those paragraphs, find those sentences, and pull that information together. And that's what Bill was a classic at achieving.